Hi, this is Richard Quack here. Welcome to another session of my video. In today's session, I would like to talk about marketing. And the topic is using webinar for promotion and marketing. All right. Now, first of all, what is a webinar? Well, as the word implies, webinar means seminar on the web. Alright, that means it is an online seminar, alright, whereby you are doing it online rather than the traditional way of doing seminar in the offline, in the hotel room and so on. Now we are doing it online. That is what it is called, a webinar, okay? Now, why do we use webinar? There are few reasons for it. Number one, we use webinar to educate our audience, alright? To educate our audience about certain topics, alright? Number two is also to train. Let's say you have a product that you are launching. You do a webinar to train people, to show people how to use your product. Okay? So it can be used for training. It can be used for list building as well, to build a list. Because people who register for your webinar, they are put into your list. So in the future, you can communicate with them and you can promote to these people as well. So list building is also relevant when you use a webinar, okay? And of course, the most important thing people use webinar is to sell, all right? You can sell because webinar can actually sell to people, because when you talk to people, you show your face, you show your presentation, and you gain trust from people, okay? Now, why is webinar important? Webinar is important because it is visual, all right? It is visual. People can see you, people can trust you. People like to see who you are, right? That's very important. Now, what would you prefer? Let me ask you this question. Which one would you prefer? Reading text or watching video? Well, I think the answer is obvious. People like to watch video, don't you think so? That's the reason why TikTok is doing very well today. TikTok, you know, is a video site which is quite recent, but they are gaining a lot of momentum outside there because it is a video site. Even YouTube, even Facebook is competing with YouTube to have a lot of video there. So video is a big thing today. And webinar is actually like a video whereby you're doing it online, all right? You're doing it online and it probably is live as well. Like what I'm doing to you with you here is a Facebook Live, but a webinar is where I can show presentation, I can show slides and so on. That is what a webinar is. So it's very, very effective for selling as well. Okay, now what are the various platforms that you can use? The most common one is GoToWebinar, all right? But the only disadvantage about GoToWebinar is that it is very, very expensive. You got to pay on a monthly basis. You know, the top internet marketing guru, they are paying few hundred dollars a month to use GoToWebinar, all right? So for new people who are going to start off new, I don't recommend GoToWebinar at all because it's very, very expensive, because there are other alternatives as well. Now, another good alternative that is free is Zoom is gaining popularity today, all right? It is free, but of course there are some limitations there. You can always upgrade and still it is reasonably priced, all right? Zoom, all right? And myself personally, we are using Zoom today, all right? Now, there are also free options with Google. Google has got Google Hangout, all right? You can use Google Hangout as well. If you got a Google account, a Gmail account, all right, then you have a Google account, then you can use Google Hangout for free. The only problem with Google Hangout is I think there's a lag time lag, you know, probably it doesn't appear immediately, it will appear a few seconds later, all right, there's a lag there, but then it is free and I think the quality is quite good as well. So Google Hangout is another option, all right. There are others outside there, like, you know, I won't recommend you. There are many outside there. You can go to make a search on Google, all right? There you can do a Google search for webinar platform, all right? You pay a one-time fee, that's all. Like I have got one that's called Ninja Webinar, all right? And a few others, whereby I pay a one-time fee and then I can use it forever, all right? And they will update the platform as well. Sometimes, you know, there are certain things that they have to change and so on. So basically, that is about webinar. Now, there's another type of webinar platform which is different from the live webinar. It is called auto webinar, all right? A live webinar is whereby you got to do the presentation live, like what I'm doing here now, live, all right? But whether, on the other hand, auto webinar is something that, you know, You don't have to be present. You do a recording, all right? You do a video recording, and then you put into a auto webinar. That means without you present, the webinar can run on its own, and it looks like it is live. Okay, that's the most important thing, is that it looks like it is going on live, because people got to register, and then they go inside the webinar room, they will see some participant there as well. All right, of course the participant is fake participant, but then you will see like it is a live webinar. These are called auto webinar. Of course, auto webinar is very effective, because you don't have to do it every single time. All right, all you need to do is do one recording, and you upload it, and basically you do the auto webinar, and when people come in, they can register and they can attend the webinar. Okay, so very interesting concept, that one. And a lot of people are using auto webinar nowadays, especially those even top internet marketer. All right, they are doing auto webinar, because to do a webinar every time is really quite time consuming. Unless it is a new launch, all right? If they launch a new product or what, then they will do a webinar, or a live webinar, which is more effective for launching new products and so on. So those are the various platforms outside there that you can use. But the most important thing is that, you know, you got to learn how to do it, all right? A webinar is not like what I'm doing here, Facebook Live here, whereby there's no PowerPoint presentation, nothing, all right? Whereas a webinar platform, I can use PowerPoint presentation, I can also use drawing sketches and a lot of other things there, all right? I can show the desktop and whatever is happening there. So basically a webinar platform is quite effective, okay, for doing selling and so on. All right, now let's talk about a little bit about the strategy, all right? The strategy involved when you want to use webinar, okay? Number one, you set up a webinar platform, all right? You still have to get people to attend the webinar. Don't you think so? People will not know that you have a webinar going on. So the best thing to do about webinar is to promote it, all right? And one of the best ways to promote that I see a lot of people doing is that they promote it on Facebook, all right? They promote it on Facebook, whether in the post or even an advertisement, you know? It can be an advertisement that they pay to get people to attend the webinar, all right? And most webinar are there, you know, to sell, all right? Of course, they must give value, but at the end of the day, they are trying to sell something, that's for sure. But they have to give value, that's important, okay? Now, how long does a webinar take? Normally it between 30 minutes to some webinar goes up to 1.5 hours, 2 hours as well. But I believe that too long also people get bored, right? It got to be about 45 minutes will be good enough, I think, you know. But of course some webinar, they got so many things to talk about, you know, it can go to 1.5 hour or so, all right? But the most important thing is I believe you got a good value to people, okay? Now let's talk about a little bit about what you should do when you have a webinar going on. Number one, you got to introduce yourself. All right, during the webinar, you got to introduce yourself. Of course, people want to know who you are and so on. Isn't it true? All right, introduce yourself, but a short introduction will do. What is your background like? What is your achievement like and so on, okay? And then the second thing, you need to know, tell people, what is this webinar about? What are you going to teach them? What are you going to talk about? That's important, all right? In fact, before they register for your webinar, they would have some information about it. But you still got to tell people what you're going to cover during the webinar and roughly how long the webinar is going to be like, okay? And the most important thing is, all right, you must tell them, because more people won't finish the webinar. It may be 1 hour, right? People might not finish your webinar. So you got to entice them to stay until the end, all right? How do you entice them to stay until the end? You tell them that, you know, stay until the end and I got a free gift for you. That is one of the reasons why people will stay just to get the free gift. So they will stay until the end of the webinar, all right? That's what you want. You don't want people to leave halfway during the webinar and so on. So you want people to stay on. And one of the best ways to do is to induce people to stay on is by giving them something, offer them something for free, okay? Maybe a free software, a free ebook or whatever it is, something for free, all right? That is of value, of course, okay? Now, the most important thing here, I think, is that you got to give content, valuable content and useful content. I know a webinar, most people use for selling, all right? But before you can sell people, you got to get trust from people. And the only way to get trust from people is to give them value. You got to teach them. All right, you got to teach them. If you don't teach them, you just outright selling to them. I tell you, you know, that's the last time they're going to attend your webinar. All right, so you got to give value to people. So you got to teach them. Of course, you don't have to teach them everything, but you got to give them some value, right? So that they're happy with you. And at the end of the day, you know, people will listen to you and probably they buy from you. All right, okay. Recently, I attended a webinar as well. You know how long is a webinar? 4 hours. It's by a very, very well-known internet marketer. It was 4 hours. All right, really long. And yet people stay back to the end because the presenter promised them something. And you know what? At the end of the day, they sold a product that's about $3,000. And yet people buy. All right, because they give valuable content. All right, but to me, I believe that, you know, people cannot sit and listen to you for too long. All right, even if you go for a movie, you know, if the movie is too long, you get bored, don't you think so? Unless it's very interesting, of course, right? But most of the movie are about 1.5 hour or so. That's about it, right? Okay, now the thing is that, you know, you got to give useful content to people. And finally, okay, you got to have engagement and interaction as well. You want to get people engaged and interact with you. So during the seminar, probably you can ask questions or you ask them to show their hand and so on. Of course, they show their hand by clicking on something there to show their hand and so on, right? But basically, you know, you want them to interact with you, all right? And where they are from and all these things, you know, important. But then you don't want to have too much disruption as well, all right? Question time, tell them, I'll answer all your questions at the end of the webinar, all right? So that there's no interruption, because interruption can really, you know, be bad for you, okay? But you need to have engagement, okay? They want to ask questions, stay until the end, okay? That's the most important thing. Now, the last thing that is important is, what is the purpose of the webinar? The purpose of the webinar, if it is to sell, then you got to have a call to action. You got to tell them, okay, what you are selling, what it's all about, and so on. And at the end of the day, you got to give them a link whereby they can go there and pay for it or register for it, okay? So a call to action is very important in anything you do, as far as copywriting is concerned, as well as selling is concerned, marketing is concerned, persuasion is concerned. There must be a call to action. You got to induce people and tell people what to do, all right? Because people sometimes, you know, they don't know what to do. So you got to tell them, instruct them what to do, because people like to be ordered around, don't you think so? Huh? Most of the people, they have been ordered around by so many people in their life, by their bosses, by their parents, and so on. So you need to order them around, all right? Tell them, okay, you want to get the thing, go to this link and click on the button, and then you get your product there, okay? Or you register there and so on. So basically, those are the few things that you need to be able to do, all right? Those are some of the strategies I'm talking with you. But anyway, webinar is very, very important. If you're doing business, then marketing is an important aspect. And one of the best way to market is to by using a webinar platform, okay? Well, for a start, use free one first, okay? You can use Zoom. Zoom is a good one, all right? In fact, they are doing very, very well today because a lot of people are using Zoom now, especially now everybody is grounded, all right? So they're going to stay at home and do the things at home. In fact, we are doing training and so on using Zoom as well, okay? So basically, that's all I want to share with you today. I hope that you learned something. I believe that, you know, using webinar platform is very, very critical to success, okay? And I will advise you that, you know, if you are doing something that is ongoing, right? Ongoing, then you can do a video, all right? Take a video of yourself, edit it as much as possible, and then do a auto webinar, all right? Because once you do the video, that's it. You know, you have to do the webinar all the time. Do an auto webinar, which is a lot of people are using that as well, all right? It saves a lot of time. You don't have to be present to do the webinar. It is recorded, so it looks like a live webinar anyway, but there are many platforms outside there. You can make a search on Google, all right? There are many platforms there, but whatever that I talk to you today, all right? If you think that you want me to recommend you a few things or give you advice, please feel free to message me, all right? So I hope you learned something here, all right? And let me summarize for you, all right? Now, people use webinar to educate, to train, okay, to build a list, and most of all, to sell, okay? And there are various platforms there, GoToWebinar, Zoom, Google Hangout, which is free as well, using AutoWebinar, which is good, all right? And in terms of strategy, all right, you can promote on Facebook, whether you do a free posting or you can advertise on Facebook. And you got to induce people to stay until the end of the webinar by promising them, you know, to stay on at the end of the webinar, you're going to give them something. And when you promise them to give them something, make sure you give them something, all right? Don't lie to them, okay? That's the most important thing. The content must be useful content, very helpful content that people can learn something, all right? And there must be engagement and interaction as well during the webinar to keep it lively, to get the audience involved as well. And of course, call to action is very important. Tell people what to do after that, okay? Instruction is important. So that's all my sharing here. I hope that you learned something here. If you like what you hear and see, please feel free to share, to like, and to comment, okay? I appreciate you for your time here, I will see you tomorrow again for another session of my video where I'm going to talk about network marketing, okay? So with that, this is Richard Quack here from Malaysia, wishing you good night and goodbye.